going to talk about genetic disorders, mainly in that I'm going to talk about Down syndrome. So coming to the genetic disorders, what are these genetic disorders and how they are caused? That genetic disorder can be caused by mutation. If there is a mutation in only one gene, then it is called as monogenic disorder. So if it is caused by the mutation in multiple genes, then it is called as multifactorial inheritance disorder. So it can also be caused by various factors, such as due to the combination of gene mutations and the environmental factors. All these will influence the mutation process, or there might be a damage to a chromosome also. So this is the start of the genetic disorders, how it occurs. So coming to the Down syndrome, so let us today understand what is Down syndrome. Okay, this Down syndrome is known as 21st trisomy. It was known as 21st trisomy because an extra chromosome is added to the 21st pair. Okay, so it is called as 21st trisomy. It was named after the physician known as John Langdon Down. So, it is described as a mongoloid child of European parentage. So, in the year 1959, a French doctor discovered that it was caused by the inheritance of extra chromosome which is present at the 21st pair. So we all know that there are 22 autosomes and 23rd pair is the sex chromosome, that is X and Y. So here in the autosome, this is an example for autosomal disorder where an extra chromosome is added to the 21st pair. Hence the name it has got, 21st trisomy. Okay, it is called as 21st trisomy because of the presence of an extra chromosome in the 21st pair. So coming to the, as I already told that Down syndrome is an autosomal disorder because it affects the chromosome 21st chromosome. It affects because of the presence of an extra chromosome in the 21st. So instead of two chromosomes, here in Down syndrome patients, due to the mutation, it will be three chromosomes in the 21st pair. So addition of one chromosome has taken place, so resulting in this defective gene. So Down syndrome is neither a dominant nor a recessive trait because it is just an error in the translation process. So as I already explained you in my previous videos about translation process, where protein synthesis occurs, likewise here also in the translation process there is an error, forming an extra chromosome is added to the 21st pair, so resulting in Down syndrome. So first let us understand what are these autosomes and what are allosomes. So autosomes means there are 22 autosomes. These autosomes, they are not involved in the reproduction process. Whereas the 23rd pair, that is which determines whether an individual is a female or an individual is a male, that is called as an allosome. Means if the 23rd pair, if it has XX, then it refers to female. If that 23rd pair, if that pair is XY, then it is known as male. So there are 22 autosomes and 23rd pair is a sex chromosome, which are also known as allosomes. Okay, now coming to the risk factors. Why this Down syndrome? Why the child is born with Down syndrome? And let us see what are the risk factors. Due to the advanced maternal age, if the mother is very old, then it might be one of the reasons for Down syndrome birth. So usually women of age 35 and above are at a very risk of giving birth to Down syndrome. So what are the physical appearance? Let us see how the baby looks. differences of this Down syndrome child. So it will have flat facial profile and then upward slant to the eye. It will have a very short neck and abnormality in the shaped ears and white spots on the iris of the eye called as brush field spots. So it will have white spots on the iris of the eye called as brush field spots. So relatively late development of dysphias and permanent teeth as compared to other children. There will be a gapping in the teeth. So teeth could appear in a different sequence and positions. The teeth may look very abnormal and there will be a fewer teeth also. There will be a fewer teeth and the child will have a protruding tongue. Okay, the tongue appears too big for the mouth, that is protruding tongue, and the teeth may be pushed out of the places as the child grows older. So what are the habits means? The children will have the habit of breathing through the mouth instead of, since the mouth will be open, the child breathes to the, it will have the habit of breathing through the mouth instead of nose, it will be breathing through the nose, sorry, mouth. So coming to the, what are those, so mental retardation will be there. In all of these genetic disorders, mental retardation is a common factor, but it varies from degree to degree. So here what happens, it varies from mild to moderate here also. Some even have a special abilities after training the child. So almost all the Down syndrome babies have mental retardation mildly to moderately. They will be retarded. It starts in the first year of the life span. So average age of the, like usually what now, the child, the sitting and the walking and the first words, what the baby does normally, it will be delayed. So IQ also, it is declined. IQ declines to the first 10 years of the age, reaching a plateau in adolescence that continues into the adulthood. So coming to the heart disease, so 50% of the Down syndrome patients have heart diseases. There will be eye problems also, and 5% of the newborns will be having cataract also. So these are the things which are the Down syndrome baby will suffer. Okay, next coming to, let us learn about the reproduction process after the adult Down syndrome man and female. Let us learn about their fertility rate and things like that. So women with Down syndrome are fertile, but nearly all males with Down syndrome are infertile due to the impaired spermatogenesis. There will be an impaired spermatogenesis in males, so they will be infertile. So, there will be skeletal abnormalities are also seen here. Skin disorders are also seen. So, what are the diagnoses? Diagnosis, it can be done by prenatal screening. It can be done. Diagnosis is, can be done by prenatal screening. If that screening is not done, it can also be recognized by the characteristic phenotypic feature because of the presence of 21st trisomy. So you during karyotyping, you can know that there will be an extra chromosome in the 21st pair. So it can be confirmed by genetic karyotyping, where it can be seen the extra chromosome. 3 chromosomes will be seen in the 21st location. So you can diagnose the disease. Mortality is, survival is better for males compared to females. The average lifespan will be around 25 to 50 years. So these are the things about Down syndrome. Thank you.